In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet Area of Regular Polygons. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Our directions say to find the area of each regular polygon. Leave your answer in simplest form. The area of a regular polygon is A equals 1/2. So 1/2 times the apothem times the perimeter. The perimeter we know is each side of the figure summed together. That is the perimeter of a polygon. The apothem is the segment from the center of the polygon to the midpoint of a side. Is the segment from the center of the polygon to the midpoint of a side. And since each of the figures are regular polygons, we know that the sides are congruent. So as opposed to adding 8 plus 8 plus 8 for a triangle, in number 1 as 3. And we can use the formula P for perimeter equals n times the length of one side. So if n is 3 and one side is 8, the perimeter equals 3 times 8. 8 plus 8 plus 8, which equals 24. So in our formula for area, we're going to have area equals 1/2 of the apothem, which is 4 times the square root of 3 over 3, and then the perimeter P, which is 24. So let's multiply the numerators together and then the denominators. 24 is the same as 24 over 1. So 2 times 3 times 1 is 6, so the denominator is 6, and the numerator is 4 times 24 equals 96. So we'll have 96 times the square root of 3. And we can simplify 96 over 6, since 96 divided by 6 is 16. So the area in number 1 equals 16 times the square root of 3. And that's because 6 goes into 96 16 times, and then we're multiplying that by the square root of 3. So 16 times the square root of 3 is our solution in number 1. In number 2, our number of sides is 7. So n equals 7, and 13.9 can be the length of one of our sides, L. So the perimeter P is going to equal 7 times 13.9. So 7 times 13.9 equals 97.3. So our perimeter of this heptagon is 97.3. And our apothem is 14.4. So area equals 1/2 of 14.4 times 97.3. So area equals, entering that into our calculator, 1/2 times 14.4 times 97.3 equals 700.56, or 756 hundredths. And that's the area of the heptagon in number 2. In number 3, the number of sides n equals 8, so this is an octagon, and the length of one side is 12. So the perimeter equals 8 times 12, which we know is 96. So our area is going to equal 1/2 of the apothem, which is 14.5, which is the segment from the center of the polygon to the midpoint of one side, and that's multiplied by our perimeter of 96. So entering each of those into the calculator, we will get 696 as our area in number 3. In number 4, we have a pentagon, so we know the number of sides n equals 5. So 7.5 times 5 is going to give us our perimeter P. 7.5 times 5 equals 37.5. So our area A equals 1/2. The segment where one endpoint is the midpoint of a side and the other endpoint is the center of the polygon, so that's 5.1. And we're multiplying that by a perimeter of 37.5. So area A equals 1/2 times 5.1 times 37.5, which gives us 95.625 for the pentagon in number 4. In number 5, the number of sides of this figure is 9. So our perimeter P is going to equal 9 times the length of the side, which is 12. 9 times 12 is 108. So 108 units is the perimeter. Our apothem is 16.5. So area equals 1/2 times 16.5 times 108, which equals 891. So 891 units squared is the area in number 5. In number 6, the number of sides in is 6. So this is a hexagon. So our perimeter P equals 6 times 10, since that's the length of one side, which is 60. So if our perimeter is 60, our area is going to equal 1/2 of the apothem, which is 5 times the square root of 3, times our perimeter of 60. Simplifying this, 5 times 60 will give us 300. So we have 300 times the square root of 3 all over 2. Simplifying, 300 divided by 2 will give us 150. So our area is 150 times the square root of 3, and that will be units squared for number 6. So 150 times the square root of 3 is the area of the regular hexagon in number 6. And number 7, it tells us that we have a regular pentagon, so the number of sides in equals 5. It gives us 7.3 is our segment from the center to the midpoint of one side, and a side is 10.6. So perimeter equals 5 times 10.6, which is 53. So area equals 1/2 of 7.3 times 53. Typing that into our calculator, we'll get 193.45. So 193.45 is our solution in number 7. And number 8, we have a triangle. So in is equal to 3. And if a side is 28 times the square root of 3, the perimeter is going to be 3 times 28 times the square root of 3, which is 84 times the square root of 3. So the area A equals 1/2 of 14 times 84 times the square root of 3. So area equals 1/2 times 14, which would be 7, and then we're multiplying that to 84, so 7 times 84 is 588, and that gets multiplied to the square root of 3. So 588 times the square root of 3 is our solution in number 8. In number 9, we have a 7 gon, so the number of sides in is 7, and a side is equivalent to 21. So the perimeter P equals 7 times 21, which is 147. So our area A equals 1/2 of 21.8 times the perimeter of 47. So area equals 1,602.3. And lastly in this video, we'll go over number 10. However, before I do the answer to this, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. In 10, we have an octagon, so the number of sides is 8. That means that the perimeter equals the number of sides, 8 times the length of a side, which is 11.7. 8 times 11.7 is 93.6. So our area A is going to equal 1/2 of the apothem, which is 14.1, times our perimeter of 93.6. Typing that into our calculator, 1/2 times 14.1 times 93.6 equals 659.88. So that is the area for number 10, 659.88 units squared. If you have any questions, leave a comment below, continue on to the next video, and don't forget, if you haven't already, click that subscribe button, and while you're at it, give me a thumbs up.